It's her birthday tomorrow. I won't see all her sorrow. She won't hear when I cry. I got to try anyhow.
Mad Artistry being with them, Eduardo De La Cruz, their Bell Eliminator helmets, one of the more comfortable helmets that Bell is making these days. It's definitely designed for motorcycling and B-twin guys. The money goes definitely to the Early Learning Coalition.
Looks like it's more.
Thank you, and there you go. I'm sure people are going to hunt you down for those trying to harm. Yep, all those. Beautiful deal. All right, stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. The auction's still going on. Feel free to come on up if you're in person and make a bid with our lovely ladies. Or if you're online, make sure you leave your bid in the comment section and have some fun.
I'm Pistol Pete. I am of the Corbin's shop in Wisconsin. I'm a Harley.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty awesome probably having those guys, you know. Just the culture in Wisconsin alone is heavy motorcycle. It's really cool. Every time I go there, going to Harley or the surrounding places, you know, I've been to a Packers game. I really like that area of the United States. I met you in Sturgis, this past Sturgis. Super cool to meet you. I was always impressed. You brought, how many bikes did you bring to Sturgis?
I think we had 7.
Yeah. And all of them, you know, big kilometers, yeah, big power, performance base, but they still have a lot of cool customer stuff. It's really cool seeing that. You know, I fell in love with your sprinters. I'm actually building, I went and bought one after seeing this one, the blue one.
Yeah.
To use some of your parts on, which I'm pretty excited about.
I'm excited too.
Yeah, it's super cool. I'm going to make you that bike at Sturgis if you go to Orlando, so. Talk to us a little bit about this bike first. It's a lot different than most Springers.
Yeah, so I've always been a fan of Springers. They're classic, they're cool. But it doesn't mean we can't have performance too.
Agreed.
So, this bike is called Bone Crusher. It went through several stages to get where it's at. We just kept building it bigger, faster, stronger. Right now it's 275 horse. We run about 18 pounds of boost through it on race fuel. So we're not done yet, but as it got bigger and faster and we made more power, other things started to fail, other things weren't
added.
So we had to develop these risers because the handlebars kept stripping out. We had to make it stop better, so we incorporated Brembo brakes and 13-inch rollers on the front. The 11.8 rear Brembo monoblock. This thing stops as good as it goes. So
cool.
Yeah. So this is. I don't think this bike gets enough attention because it's just black. But that was kind of the point.
I think those in the know understand what's going on with this thing, and those that don't are like, cool. You know, either way you win.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Yep.
I mean, just to see that the technology you use to get those autoblock calipers on the front is, I mean, I was thoroughly impressed. And that takes a lot to impress me because I've seen everything.
Well, I appreciate it.
What turbo setup was that?
So, we work exclusively with Trask Performance. I have a great relationship with those guys. So we use Trask Turbo Systems. Thunder Max, we have a great relationship with them. We tune everything in-house, Thunder Max, ECM, and that's the only way to go, I guess.
Oh yeah, it's good stuff with twin cams and Dean. Tell us a little bit about this guy, this blue super duper performance battery, which also has a Trask turbo on it.
Yeah, but a lot of our builds have turbos. We like the big power.
So, I like it.
And all our motors are built from the crank pin out, welded through, balanced. ARP head studs, we make sure they're bulletproof when they leave.
Yeah, I mean, there's no other way. If you're going to put forced induction on a bike, you can't just do it with a stop. I mean, they're going to pull head studs right out.
Yep.
I mean, they make a lot of power, but they internally, they make a lot of friction.
I'm not going to lie, I've learned by my failures.
Most people are like, oh, I'll just get a turbo and slap it on there and double my horsepower. Okay, have fun with that.
Yeah. So, and here's another one. This is 200 horse. This is a 107 Pistol Pete's boost engine. But here again, the power, there was things lacking, so suspension and brakes and things like that. So I got with Owens suspension, I got with Brembo brakes again. We developed this front end for this bike to incorporate all that suspension. So we have a full line of parts coming out, so you can convert your bike into something like this.
I love hearing that.
So, yeah. Lucky 13, this one is called.
Super cool.
I don't want to tell the whole story behind it, but so, yeah.
It's such, you know, your bikes are really clean, but also, you know, if you look at the tires and you look at certain telltale things, you ride your bikes. You know, yes, this is a show bike, but it's in a show, but you can tell these bikes have been ridden.
My customers ride the hell out of these bikes, and that is what is so fun.
I love
that. We get to make something that they use, and we test, and we keep getting better as you find the next weak link.
Yeah, I think it's great, man. And I appreciate you coming to the Wheels of Steel show and being part of it, and, you know, taking the trip down from Wisconsin, and, you know, I can't thank you enough, and I know everybody here loves seeing your bikes, so. Keep up the good work, man.
I want to say thanks to everybody involved with us, and thanks for having us. It's been great.
Awesome. Cheers, man.
Awesome.
Thanks, Jeff. I get all nervous.
Wheels of Steel, Central Florida.
Finding out. the most amazing family.